When I was 14, I started my own business. When I was 18, I got my beauty degree. Then I opened my first salon in the markets.
I know you've been through it. I know you've been.
It was only 2 meters wide. It was tiny. Then I started doing hair from my dad's kitchen. I was determined to save every penny so I could finally open my dream salon. When I was 20 years old, I did achieve that dream and I opened my second salon and I also started my hair company. At 21, I was running the hottest, most in-demand salon, but it was also the hardest time of my life. My staff stole everything from me, meaning that I had to start all over from the bottom again. And I was this close to giving up. It really, really broke my spirit, but I learned to keep going and keep fighting for what you want to achieve. A year later, I was the most highest paid weavetician in the entire country. I had a salon that was so banging that I wasn't even accepting new clients. Overdue for your loving, baby. I don't want no one else. Ain't no way I would do you dirty. I'm now 25 and I am running a massive international company with employees, celebrity clients all around the world, and I did it.
This is exclusive.
Nothing can stop me, I'm all the way up. All the way up. I'm all the way up. I'm all the way up. Nothing can stop me, I'm all the way up. All the way up. I'm all the way up. I'm all the way up. Nothing.
When you're installing the lace and the perimeter, the first thing that you want to do is do not. So don't be scared to cut lace. This is actually cutting perfectly to the size. It's gonna fit, like for example, I know this is gonna fit perfectly, but I know this isn't. You can easily cut the lace off, and what you're doing is you're customizing the lace cap to actually fit your customer's head shape. Just make sure that you're lifting the lace off the client's hair. So can you see how already, how much better that's sitting? When you're cutting it, don't cut too much, just go little bit by little bit. Start to position it and then see how it's fitting. If you cut it too much, it's really hard to make it perfect. So once you put the wig on, now we want to measure the lace to see where we're going to cut it and actually turn it into the U part.
So we've got the frontal here that we're going to be using. It's a 13-inch by 4. Then we've got.
So one of the ways that you can sew is by putting the needle up. Make sure you're not grabbing too many holes in the net. A lot of people make mistakes by grabbing like this many, and then by the time it's stitched, it's actually going to be gaping, and this is going to cause your wig cap to get a lot smaller.
finished double back stitching the back, you'd want to make sure that you leave all of this lace completely loose. So the lace that I'm using is transparent, but to customize it perfectly to my client's skin tone, you just want to hold the ear tabs of the frontal. If you cut the lace in a C-shaped angle, then you'll also get coverage on your sideburn.
Really secure with no glue.
Experience hate, but you need to learn to channel it into something positive and achieve more. Yourself apart and make yourself unique from everyone else. You have to make sure that you're confident. If you're not confident in what you're selling or the service that you're offering, how do you expect customers to be confident in you?